Welcome to the ultimate relative scale model of our beautiful solar system. In today's demonstration, we will be covering the vast parts of our solar system all the way out to Saturn. To create my solar system model, I used clay, styrofoam balls, and wire. I've put together a relative sized planet next to our sun so that you can grasp the sheer size of our solar system. This gray speck of Plato is the planet Mercury. Next to it is Venus, then Earth, and Mars. Following that is our beautifully painted Jupiter and finally styrofoam Saturn and its rings. We will begin this journey at our beach ball replica of the exploding star at the center of our solar system. The sun is our powerhouse when it comes to moving across the galaxy. While we orbit around the sun, it orbits around the Milky Way galaxy, taking us along with it. Let us move forward to our first planet. Mercury is the first neighboring planet to the sun. The planet of Mercury was a troublesome planet. We had a difficult time as we attempted to calculate the rotation of this planet. We used radar waves to bounce off Mercury and send it back to Earth. Through the Doppler effect, we were able to figure out which side of Mercury was rotating from us and towards us. Moving on. Venus. Venus is our scorching hot, slow-moving twin of a planet. You would think when you hear that we have a twin planet, why haven't we inhabited it? Well, to answer that question, the only ways that Venus is our twin planet is by its mass and diameter. Other than those two characteristics, Venus has a completely different atmospheric composition density, composition of clouds, lengths of days, surface temperature, number of moons, and magnetic field. Basically, Venus is different from Earth in almost every way possible but size. Onward we go. Ah, home sweet home. Our big ball of dirt floating through the vacuum of space. But at least we aren't alone all the way out here. We have our great and wondrous rock, the moon, who supports our way of life. The moon's orbit actually sustains and controls a lot of our tides and wind speeds on our planet. Without the moon's tidal friction, the Earth would be extremely different than what it is now. Whenever we begin to think about our immediate problems and all the stress that people have to deal with in this pandemic and a bunch of things that are just clouded our brains and our media, remember, we are all just talking monkeys on an organic spaceship hurtling through the universe. Let's move forward. Also, to test whether this model is accurate, you can hold up your pinky from Earth's position and the sun should cover up about half the width of your pinky. Our moon is about 3,400 kilometers away from us. To put it in our model solar system perspective, that would be roughly 25 centimeters. The moon's diameter is also about a quarter of our own diameter. Here in this quick stop motion animation of our moon, I'm demonstrating the counterclockwise and synchronous rotation of our moon. The face of the moon that we see in our sky doesn't change due to the speed of its rotation being tidally locked and synchronous with Earth's. Next up, Mars, home of the aliens' first experiment of Earth gone wrong. Just kidding. Although that would be a crazy theory. Astronomers used to speculate about life on Mars. But ultimately, as technology advanced, we innovated our telescopes for a more crisp visual grasp of the rocky planet. We were able to observe and realize that there was no water flow or advanced life on the desolate planet. There are many interesting things about Mars that leave conspirators and scientists still invested in its research. For example, Elon Musk. He is still preparing to venture out to the orange rock and possibly inhabit it. Since this walk is pretty lengthy, I also wanted to mention Matt Damon's great work in the film The Martian. Another amazing fact, actually, about Mars is that we have rovers there. We have things from Earth on this planet. And to think that humans have not even gone that far, but our technology has, is also an amazing fact. Chewie, hit the hyperdrive. Jupiter, the monstrous giant of our solar system. The giant planet is to be feared by all for its massive storms and raging winds. The great red spot of Jupiter is a beautiful yet terrifying landmark of Jupiter, reaching the span of three Earths. The moons of Jupiter are quite fascinating due to their size and fixed ratio orbits. From closest to farthest, we have Io, Europa, Ganymede, and Callisto. Io orbits Jupiter with a 2-to-1 ratio to Europa and a 4-to-1 ratio with Ganymede. This means that every time Io revolves around Jupiter 2 times, Europa has only completed 1 revolution. And again, the time it takes Ganymede to go around Jupiter once, Io has completed 4 revolutions. Finally, the last planet of our journey to this model of the solar system. We reach Saturn and its wonderful shining rings it bought from the Pandora jewelry store. Just kidding, but they are made of billions of small rocky ice and dust that we can only see because of their reflective characteristics.